Ladies and gentlemen, it looks like I've made a mistake with my build. So it's been a few days and people are slowly learning which builds are gonna end up being most dominant to start NBA 2K19. And things can always get patched, so you never know if you create a dominant build and then it's no longer dominant because of a change. So you gotta create another build and that gets patched. But all I know is I don't wanna play with a subpar build, so I'm creating a new one. The build I previously had, I never really told you guys about in a video, is this 6'4 sharpshooting playmaker. It's a play shooter. I grinded him to 88 overall so far, and I got all of the, like, I got the gold picker on Maestro. I maxed out a lot of the shooting badges. It was pretty simple, but I made some mistakes. In the process, I made him a point guard instead of a shooting guard, even though everyone told me to make him a shooting guard, because if you make your play shooter a shooting guard, you get silver catch and shoot and silver deep range Deadeye, and I have bronze. On top of that, I found that this build does a horrible job of attacking the rim. Even when I blow by people and I go up for layups, if there's somebody there, I get blocked. And then I played with Mike Krzemba the other day, who had a pure sharpshooter, and he was hitting all of the contested layups. So things have definitely changed. I've literally been practicing dribbling the last like week or so I can get a little bit better at least. Cause here's my thinking, I'm already fantastic at shooting and I'm in the process of trying to create some dribble moves. That video might come sometime tomorrow. But check this out, this is the most recent move I've been trying to work on. Okay, no, I f***ed it out one more time. Boom, boom. Yes, hallelujah. So I can't do that in game with the pressure of people spamming square, but I can do it in my court with no pressure whatsoever. Jeez! Anyway, I just figured like this play shooter build is fine. I could probably still rock with it, but like at the end of the day, here's the problem I'm having. Shot creators will and already are taking over the game. So let me just tell you some stories. Yesterday, I was streaming on Facebook. By the way, follow my stream. I've been streaming there every single day on NBA 2K19. I saw a post-scoring primary, shot creator secondary hitting contested shots. A big man. I was watching Annoying Stream. The dude is 6'3". He made a smaller build than mine, and he attacks the rim and dunks more than my build, because shot creators tend to go up for more dunks than play shooters. When you're going for a shot contest, because this year you can't automatic shot contest, you have to push the right stick to go up for the contest. And it's easy to do if somebody has to stand still to shoot, because there's a buffer from when they stand still and go up for their shot. But if they're moving on their shot, it becomes a lot more difficult to contest. Especially if you're a small player, you have a low height, and you have a small wingspan, then like, how do you even contest? You have to start clicking triangle. And then you're gambling at that point, right? Because you never know if he's gonna fake you out and then zigzag the other way and hit you with some cheese. I feel like on defense my build is fine. I don't think I'm too vulnerable. Occasionally the slasher or the pure point forward might hit me with a blow by. It happens. But as long as I have good defensive possession, I thought that defense might be this build's weakest point. But in reality, a shot maker only has two or three less three-point shooting attributes than this build. It has worse shooting badges, admittedly, but it has way better playmaking badges. And I think as a whole, whether you're playing twos or threes on the park and even on Pro-Am, I think the shot maker is the way to go. So instead of recreating this build and putting him at shooting guard, I don't even want that play shooter anymore. But then things got even better. So you guys watched my video earlier today. I talked about how NBA 2K Lab hit me up and said, if you get an 86 open shot three or higher, you can get that pure perfect window. In NBA 2K19, if you have an 86 open shot three or higher, you can hit the small 6 to 8 millisecond window where 100% of the shots you take green light. Now you might be thinking, Agent, how could a human being ever possibly hit a 6 to 8 millisecond window consistently? We're not robots and we don't have modded controllers. That's a really good point that you make. I brought up that point too when my guys at 2K Lab told me that. I described it in all the details and what it means in the video. If you missed it, I'm gonna leave a card above and a link in the description. So I was like, this is my new plan. I wanted a player that can not only hit 86 ball control to speed boost, but 86 open shot three so I can hit that pure perfect green window. You might be thinking, Agent, what build can possibly do that? Well, here's the thing that's challenging to know, because in 2K, when you go in the game to create your build, it gives you the max caps, but you have to grind to 99 to reach all those max caps. So there's some builds like a shot creator primary, sharpshooter secondary, you could put him at point guard, make him 6'1", and he could reach both of those. The only problem is we don't know when he's gonna reach 86 ball control. It could be at 95 overall, 96 overall, and for me, it's too big of a risk to find out. I don't want to grind to 99. Last thing I want is to grind and spend all this time on a player that never ends up reaching his potential that I wanted him to reach, the reason I built him. So I've been doing some more analysis. Check this out. Shot creators in general, if you could put shot creator in your build and your build will be dominant. I've been looking through lists and lists and lists of badges, and so if you put shot creator on anything, ladies and gentlemen, it's like Nutella. You could put it on anything and it's gonna be delicious, all right? So check out the shot creator badges on NBA 2K Lab. Lists and lists, right? Shot creators get the benefit of having playmaker badges and sharpshooter badges on top of their shot creator badges. You see all the silver shooting badges like Hornet Specialist, Limitless Range, Catch and Shoot. If you scroll down, you can even see Dimer on silver on a pure shot creator. But you get Deep Range Deadeye, which is an exclusively a sharpshooter badge. You get slasher badges like Posterizer. It's part of the reason why I think shot creator is going to be the wave this year. Not only is it an easy build to master, it's not a hard build to use, so anybody can pick it up and do it, but when you do pick it up, it ends up being the best build in the game. So check this out. The badges are straight on the pure shot creator, right? I went on the attribute cap site, so look on the left side of the screen. The right side is a shot maker, shot creator primary, playmaker secondary. The left side here, build one, is a pure shot creator. Now, we're looking for two attributes. One is the open shot 3.82. Now here's my thinking, and I hit up NBA 2K Lab and they said they would do some testing and get back to me. If I can use the +5 boosts that are there, you know that little kiosk with the girl who's really trying to smash, you know who I'm talking about? If I use those +5 boosts to get to 86 or even 87, then I can hit that pure perfect window. And then if you scroll down and look at ball control, it reaches the 87. And these are the max caps, right? So maybe at 92 or 93 overall, I'll finally get enough ball control and 3-point shooting to do what I want with this build. And keep in mind, the build itself, like what height did I make it? I made it 6'1". It's a very short build. So, I mean, there's some negatives. It's gonna be easier to contest. On defense, I have no idea how it'll hold up, especially if you're playing against like a pure point forward, right? How could you possibly keep up with that? You're gonna have to spam square the entire time. But luckily, in this game, there's not nearly as many blow-bys. So defensively, as long as you're good, you're sound, and you're on point, you shouldn't have too many problems. Depending on 2K Lab's answer, if you cannot use boosts to reach 86, then it might change things. But if you can, this might be my new build, and I'm waiting to find out. Until then, for those who don't know, because I haven't really talked about it much, I still have my pure sharpshooter, and he's 85 overall, he's 6'5", and I might change the height to make a new build. I'm not entirely sure on the details yet, but I'm gonna start grinding my sharpshooter because I know I'm gonna want a sharpshooter build at the end of the day. So I made a mistake in grinding that play shooter first, but I'd rather start over now than 2 months from now be pissed off every time like I'm playing against a shot maker or a pure shot creator and they're dropping me off. Can you imagine if not only on open, standing threes, you can hit that pure perfect window because you have a fantastic rating, but on top of that, you can speed boost with your build, so you can stand still shoot, move shoot, you can dribble and speed boost, oh my goodness. It is the perfect offensive build. And then you start to factor in the badges, the ankle breaker on silver, right? The dimer on silver, the shooting badges on silver, on top of the, if we go back, we forgot to mention, difficult shots on Hall of Fame, tireless scorer on Hall of Fame, mid-range, Deadeye on Hall of Fame. There's a good chance this could be the most popular build in the game 1 month from now, and I just wanna get ahead of things. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. The only thing I'm gonna miss in having this build is that gold pick and roll maestro, man. It is a thing of beauty, and you only have it on silver, I believe, yeah, on the pure shot creator. Pick and roll maestro, oh my goodness. Like, if you're a pure playmaker, that thing is a blessing. It literally gives you, like, sharpshooter-esque shooting attributes coming off a screen, and then you already have the speed coming off the screen to get places first and get open shots. So, like, there's plenty of ways you can dominate. I'm not saying this is the only way or the best way, but if everything pans out and I make this build here, ladies and gentlemen, anyway, that's my thinking. I'm starting over. I'll still keep that play shooter. You never know when like a patch might hit and play shooters might be more valuable. Like for example, if 2K drops a patch and they make shot contests more significant. So if you put a hand up, it drops the attribute more. You see what I'm saying? If shot contests mean more for whatever reason, that's gonna be a huge blow to shot creators. But then if that happens, I'll still have my play shooter to fall back on. So that's literally a win-win for me. Anyway, I'm gonna get to grinding. If you guys enjoyed the video, drop a like, subscribe to the channel. I wanted to keep you guys updated because you guys are like, Agent Bro, what builds are you making? And I never really came out and definitively said, but this is kind of where I'm at right now. I also have another build I'm making on the wing, and that's probably gonna be for Pro-Am, and I'm gonna start grinding him tomorrow. And I'm gonna wait on that announcement because my guy iPod King Carter put me on and it looks like it can be one of the best builds in the game. and nobody's talking about it. Catch you guys in the next one. If you guys enjoyed, actually click on one of these two videos. Just do it. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. I'm out. Peace.